Hello friends, welcome back to another tutorial. Here I am going to discuss all this point step by step. So let's go to the topic. The topic is Bissler-Napieralesky reaction. It is nothing but the method for the synthesis of isoquinoline. Before we discuss about Bissler-Napieralesky reaction, first we need to know about the isoquinoline and quinoline structure. The isoquinoline is a heterocyclic aromatic compound. Also, it is aromatic compound, organic compound, and it is a structural isomer of quinoline. So this one is isoquinoline and this one is quinoline. And isoquinoline and quinoline both are benzopyridine, which are composed of a benzene ring fused with a pyridine ring. Now this isoquinoline can be synthesized by mainly three methods. The first one is Bissler-Napieralesky reaction, and the second one, that is Pictet-Spengler reaction, and third one, that is Pomarange reaction. Now here I will discuss about the first one, that is Bissler-Napieralesky reaction. That is the synthesis of isoquinoline by Bissler-Napieralesky reaction. And another two methods I will discuss on the other video. So if you have not subscribed to our channel, then please subscribe us, because when we upload about these two methods, then you will get notification. Now let's go to the topic. The Bissler-Napieralesky reaction is an intramolecular electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction that allows for the cyclization of beta-aryl ethyl amides or beta-aryl ethyl carbamates. That is, here this is the overview. Here it is monosubstituted benzene ring, and this was amide like structure. Under treatment with POCl3 or phosphorus pentoxide or PCl5, depending on the situation, you can use. And finally flowed by palladium carbon to give isoquinoline. That is, this one is the overview of Bissler-Napieralesky reaction. But most commonly used phosphoryl chloride, that is POCl3, followed by benzene or toluene under heating condition. Now what is the mechanism of this reaction? And the mechanism is quite simple. We take monosubstituted benzene ring, that is this one, and this one is the amide like structure. In presence of phosphoryl chloride, then this lone pair or nitrogen atom, when it falls here, this can attack to this phosphorus atom, and one chlorine remove as a chloride, and finally we get the imine. So this is the formation of imine. And this one and this one is the resonance stabilize. After the formation of imine like salt, then this imine undergo electrophilic substitution reaction take place, followed by cyclization. So this one comes here. So we get a cyclized product, that is this one. Now here the removal chloride anion, it will take this hydrogen, and this bond falls here. So we get this one. Now when this one takes this hydrogen, this bond shifted here and this bond removed. So we get dihydroisoquinoline derivative. So after removal of hydrogen chloride and PO2Cl, we will get dihydroisoquinoline derivative. After dehydrogenation or aromatization in presence of palladium carbon, palladium charcoal, it will get isoquinoline derivative. So this is the process to synthesis the isoquinoline. Now go to one more problem, that is this one. Here this one also amide like structure, and under treatment with phosphoryl chloride, benzene with reflux, and second one, that is palladium charcoal. So here we will get also this same type of product, that is this one. Now the most important point about Bissler-Napier-Lyski reaction is, first one, it is a intermolecular reaction, and second one, that is it will undergo aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction, and third one, that is cyclization takes place, and the reagent is phosphorus, phosphoryl chloride, and dehydrating agent, and the starting material, that is beta-aryl ethyl amides or beta-aryl ethyl carbamates, and it was first discovered in 1893 by Bissler and Napier-Lyski. Now another two method for the synthesis of isoquinoline, that is Pictet-Spengler reaction and Pomarange reaction, that can be also explained in another video. At last, a small request to you. If you have not subscribed to my channel till now, so please subscribe right now. If you find this video useful, then please share with your friends and click the like button below. For more videos, click on the subscribe button. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.